Hello everyone, and welcome to episode 10 of Fallout New Vegas. So, we had a little crash last time, and by little I mean huge, so the point where the save no longer works. But, anyway, we're gonna have to redo that fight. Now, Big John isn't a very smart man, but after this fight, he learns that, you know, wow, that was just terrible. I cannot speak right now. Okay, I don't care. I'm just gonna do the fight and then I'll do my intro. Because, you know, I'm supposed to... God damn it. Alright, let's just go. Alright, so we're gonna talk with this guy, kill him. And, get back to it. Like I ruined my plan. Well, anyway. Shit. Alright, I'll see the same. Well, anyway. Alright. Sorry, my guy. Alright. But yeah, Mercer. I went flying. Anyway, mercy pistols.
Don't worry. I think your eyes will see more than I could ever tell you.
Man, this guy's a feisty little bastard. I'm impressed.
Thank you.
coming for you, old bastard. Anyway, I'm going to take this moment to explain to you what's going through Big John's head right now. So Big John, he's big, he's strong, but he's a very intelligent. He's a man of few words. As you can see me struggling with trying to get that one lady on board to fight the Power Raiders, whatever. But Big John does know the difference between right and wrong. And what he saw here was wrong. With that in mind, he now knew that Caesar's Legion was bad, and he was going to make sure of it first. But if he was right and Caesar's Legions are as bad as this one guy showed, he now has one mission. He always wanted to clean up the wasteland, always wanted to make a difference. That's why he liked the MCO. It believed in something that was good from the past, and that was enough for him. But now, if Caesar's Legion is as bad as things are, he's going straight for the head of this Caesar that people are speaking of. He's going to decapitate Caesar with his trusty shovel and make sure Caesar's Legion never comes to rule the Mojave. Now, that being said, he has some people that were slaved, which he wants to rescue. But he knows he can't do many fights like this yet. So at least he's going to go see if the NCR can give him some help. He doesn't want to do it all alone, and he doesn't think he has to. But he will, if he needs to. Anyway, let's get back into it. So, let's drop some stuff. Okay, I need to drop some crap. And the swiftness of the Ranger is still talked about today. Texas red and black cleared leather for a bullet fairly ripped. And the Ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his heel. Alright, time to fast travel. It was over. Actually, let's look at a request first. Booted, rescued the captives. We're definitely going to go there at some point. I have to report to this guy, that's the next quest. Let's see if we can't get a companion for that though. Hopefully the love will appear, be able to head back to Cold Springs, wherever it's called. With being leveled up. Oh shit, mercenary?
Hey there.
That's not good.
Hey there. Need in?
So, just so you guys know, I have recorded all the way to this episode, all one block. I started at like 8, and now it's 2:30 in the morning, so this is going to be the last episode of the night. And sorry if I didn't do anything you guys talked about in the comments. Work for you, but nothing else on the radar at the moment.
Take care. Cool your heels over in the barracks if you want.
Alright. So apparently we need to up our speech a little bit, so we'll put 5 more points into this. Oh, I still point in here for a chance of maybe getting it.
Appreciate the help. No, I mentioned you might accidentally get supplied, and I meant it. Not allowed to contract mercenaries at the outpost. Still, a requisition form or two can get lost, and they're not gonna come check. So here you go, just between us.
Thanks.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
100 bottle caps, shit. What the hell is going on here? Get off the platform.
You check out the Nipton Town Hall yet? Smoke trail's not getting any shorter. Legion this far west?
Yep.
You're fucking kidding me. That's not outside the border. They're moving in, and fast. Nipton wasn't the most friendly town, but... All right. Thanks for checking on that. Wish it set my mind at ease. Now I'm more on edge than ever. In Nipton? Hell no. Town was a shithole, asking to be burned. Just not by Legion. Nobody deserves that.
No.
Well, thanks for hoofing it there and back, even if it was bad news. Wish we could spare the troops to go hunting, but orders are to stay put. Fucking Mojave's going to hell, and all I can do is sit here and watch. Thanks for the assist. Wish others around here had your drive. Thanks for the assist. Wish others around here had your drive.
I guess that's it for here. I expect to kind of get more, kind of like cleared out the Legion there, but nobody cares, I guess.
I'm not sure you should be here.
Yeah, fuck.
Appreciate the help. What if you stay?
Well, anyway, let's head back to Good Springs. Oh my god. Let's go outside first. You can be I can just drink all my health back, can I? This is a little bit cheap. Been out in Mojave all day. Good drinking, nothing bad. Yeah. So Caesar Legion bad, that's all we know. I just realized the main quest probably has to go fix the, go save the, prisoners anyway, because they have an idea of where the checkered man is. Yeah, that was some good tasty water. You know, I think I make a good pattern here if I actually wanted to join them, considering that I can... I like explosives. I just do. Oh, for God's sake, did I start recording? Thank God. Alright, so episode 10. We're doing the big finale that we meant to do in episode, like, 1. Let's clear them out. At least the moon still looks intact. Now, if I say Victor again,
Howdy. I'll keep an eye out for the powder gangers and meet up with you and Ringo when the time comes.
Man, you are such just like.
Until next time.
She's like an actual decent person in Mojave, not fucked up in any shape or form, just having to live in as a dog. Damn. What a nice gal. And you, sir, need to go get a job. You should not be drinking this much. Where's Jane?
You looking to buy some supplies? You made your point. I can provide people with some leather armor and extra ammo. Sure hope it's worth it. And I'll be guarding the store while all this is going on. I have to put my business first. You understand.
Alright, where's the surplus ammo?
It's all about quantity over quality. Trouble is, you'll be cleaning and fixing your gun a lot more than usual when you use those kind of bullets. Weapon mods are things like silencers, scopes, bigger magazines. Special ammo includes things like armor-piercing bullets, which don't hurt the target as much, but let you punch through armor easily. There's also hollow-point bullets, which have the opposite effect. You can kill unarmored targets easier, but they don't do shit against armor.
Have you ever been to New Vegas?
Twice. Both times I drank a lot of liquor and lost most of my caps at the card tables. In that order, now that I think about it. If you ever get to New Vegas, be sure to visit Gamora. It's the best casino in the city. You won't regret it. Word of advice, behave. Between the NCR military police and Mr. House's robots, you don't want to be causing trouble on the strip.
Who is Mr. House?
I'm afraid I don't know much myself. Mr. House has got his own casino, Lucky 38, but nobody goes in or out except his robots. The other casinos follow Mr. House's rules, so I guess that makes him the leader of New Vegas. As far as I know, nobody's ever laid eyes on the guy. I think that robot who pulled you out of the dirt belongs to Mr. House. If Mr. House is looking after you, it's got to be a good thing, right? They're tough sons of bitches. Mean, but not crazy. They'll leave you alone unless you got something they want. The Great Khans deal in illegal chems. There's a good chance that most chems you come across were made by Great Khans.
Hmm. Alright, well.
Take it easy now.
Nice day. Alright. Let's do this thing. One more girl to get on board. Who are you?
Howdy.
Got a lot of armor for a settle. Did you have that much armor in the first couple episodes? I'll have to look back when I'm at it.
Feeling thirsty? I can take care of that.
You're not even in the pocket.
I was planning on sitting this one out, but for some reason, I can't help but like you. I'm with you. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, We could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock.
Alright. Well. Bye.
Be careful out there.
I will. You know, I'm not really trusting this document.
What's the plan? Are we ready? All right, I'm ready.
All right, let's do this.
I hope.
Time to look alive. The Powder Gangers are here to play. They're getting set up in cover, but it might not go well unless we get out there soon. At least six. They look pretty mean.
All right, let's go.
Oh, EZP came through with the dynamite. Here's your supply. I really hope I don't blow myself up. I'll be set up near the store. Let's hope that the gang doesn't manage to make it that far.
Yeah, Cold Town really did turn out. Alright, let's see if we get any Powder Gang armor still. Nope. Shit. Nope. Let's start with dynamite. Attempt to get out the good old fashioned shovel. Alright, that's all she wrote. Let's get some loot.
I owe you a huge favor for this. Here, these are technically Crimson Caravan funds, but
I haven't actually heard this
one. I know they'll understand once I explain things.
You're welcome.
I'll stick around for a bit longer, but I'll be gone in a few days. If you ever visit New Vegas, look me up at the Crimson Caravan camp. Thanks again for all your help.
Rules, Caravan.
It's a two-player game, and the winner takes the whole pie. You build a caravan using the cards in your deck. The goal is to create caravan bids that beat your opponent's bids. So there's more strategy than luck involved. It's why you won't see caravan in any casino. Too slow-paced. And more importantly, no house edge. Here, take this holotape. It goes into more specifics about the rules. You'll also need a deck, so take one of my spares. So, you feel like playing a game?
Yeah. What's the point? I'll be done with the episode.
Don't worry. I'm not that good of a player.
Yes, I've got heartaches by the number of love that I can't win. But the day that I stop down, that's the day my world will end. Heartache number three was when you called me. What?
Thanks again for all your help. Sure.
What just happened to the quality? I should read the rules. What is going on?
Thanks again for all your help. I've never stopped here until recently. You're better off asking one of the
Oh, I can't see. What is going on? There we go. What's that? Big man bag.
Thanks again for all your help.
No problem.
Yeah.
If you're looking for supplies, chat over at the general store can help.
That'll teach the powder gangs to avoid good springs in the future. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
Yeah, I was hoping there's something more I could do, like, for you as a companion. Alright.
We need more people like you around.
No problem.
Hey there.
Alright, well, this is looking like the end of the episode, guys.
Sure.
So be sure it's true when you say I love you.
Alright, I don't need anything from you.
I don't see.
Oh, there's more. When
you say I love you. Sure, I can help.
No.
Well, I already told you I came from a vault. After that, I was a traveling doctor for a spell. It seemed like a good idea at the time. Most folks out here ain't educated, so people with medical know-how are hard to come by.
True.
I found that I could help a lot of people with what I knew, and that was all right with me.
Good man.
Eventually, I went back and married my childhood sweetheart, and that was the end of my traveling days. Didn't miss it none then. Still don't. If you break
my heart,
Well, ain't we all, right? That was a long time ago. So be sure I don't pay it much mind anymore.
When you
say I love you. This here's Good Springs, named after the water we got here, just down the road to the southeast. Good Springs Source, they call it. It's a quiet town, and that's how we like it. We don't go looking for trouble, though occasionally it sees fit to come looking for us. Well, there's a general store just up the road, run by a fella named Chet. He don't got nothing fancy, but he's got your basics covered. If you're looking to wet your whistle, just past Chet's is the Prospector Saloon. The bartender there, Trudy, knows everyone in town. Other than that, there's not much to see. Just people trying to scratch out a living. You know what I'm talking about. That'd be Victor. Curious fella. He's sort of odd, and I don't just mean because he's a robot. I couldn't tell you much about him. He's real friendly, don't get me wrong. I just get the sense that that ain't the whole picture. Just a feeling. He keeps to himself, mostly. You want to know more about him, you'll have to ask him yourself. He has a shack on the southern edge of town. I didn't see him or the men with him. You might ask around town, though. Could be someone saw which way they was headed. Your best bet would probably be Trudy, the bartender at the saloon up the road. If anyone saw anything, she'd know about it. Well,
general store, like whistle. Other than that, not much to see. All right, goodbye.
You take care.
So we did the thing. Let's end episode 10. Still don't have a companion, sadly. Next episode, it looks like we're gonna go rescue some slaves and kill some possible slavers, and then, we'll see where to go from there. Maybe it'll finally be time to go to New Vegas. I probably should have just gone there in the first episode. It would have been a good time. Talk to him for the last bit of episode 10.
Howdy, partner.
He knows not who's talking.
Can't say that I'm familiar with the rascals. Some of the fine folks in town might be able to help you out with that.
How did you end up in the train?
I moseyed into town, 10, 15 years ago. Before that, I can't quite seem to recall. Odd. Anyway. It's a right peaceful town, and I reckon it's as fine a place to settle as any.
First, I have an audio option to
happy
talk
trails.
About. surprised there's no audio option for me to confront him about how he hired me, which then led to me getting shot. Strange. He's not going to be in his house, is he? Oh, he is. Shit. Wow, this is clean for a robot. Why does a robot need bed? So it's so clean because he isn't using it.
Howdy, partner.
Keep talking about anything else? Nope. Well, I'm over encumbered. That's the end of episode 10.
Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6", made 245, okay. Kind of broad at the shoulder, narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John. Big John.
What the heck is going on here?
Big John. Big bad John.
Big John. Why is things moving? Is that
Nobody
a satellite?
Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone.
What the hell's happening here?
Didn't say much, kind of quiet and shy, but he spoke it all. He just all
right,
said,
I'm talk to
Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen and a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land, Big John.